That's a fighting song, Tom.
Oh, man, the Mean Street Posse.
From the fighting streets of Greenwich, Connecticut. We know that last month of Survivor Series, Stone Cold Steve Austin suffered head, neck, and back injuries as a result of a hit-and-run attack outside the Joe Louis Arena. Finally, all the tests and exams have been completed on Stone Cold, and it's been decided that Stone Cold Steve Austin will undergo surgery in the near future. Earlier this week, Stone Cold met with renowned spinal cord specialist Dr. Henry Bowman in Cleveland. Following the examination, it's been determined that Austin will need to have surgery to relieve pressure on the nerves of his upper spine. And for more information on Stone Cold's injury and surgery, log on to WWF.com.
From Chicago, Illinois, weighing 268 pounds, D'Lo Brown.
Well, a lot of people feel that D'Lo Brown's the greatest European champion of all time here in the World Wrestling Federation. And last Thursday on SmackDown, Val Venus looked to get involved in D'Lo's opportunity to regain that title, pounding away on the British Bulldog. But for Val's troubles, it was a sky high. Now, D'Lo was denied that European title, but Tom, I have a feeling that D'Lo Brown is going to look to get his hands on that gold sooner or later.
Obviously, D'Lo didn't appreciate Val coming in and ruining his chance to get that championship back. And I've got to believe that he wants to get a little revenge on Val.
And talk about revenge and championships. Boy, as Joey Abs starts off very quickly, what about China and Chris Jericho? The ninth wonder of the world will defend the Intercontinental title, broken thumb and all, against Y2J. Next Sunday on pay-per-view at Armageddon.
And Jericho wants to get some revenge exactly for the humiliation that he suffered before and get the Intercontinental Championship around his waist.
Well, of course, Monday on Raw, we all heard Chris Jericho whining and complaining about the hammer shot, saying that China had given him a concussion, of course, on Thanksgiving night. Now, I have a little bit of speculation there, but no denying the moonsault off the second rope and a near fall for D'Lo Brown. I wonder if Jericho may have been playing up those injuries a little bit more than was necessary, but you can't deny China definitely is going in there following a shattered thumb.
How many times have you been hit in the head with a hammer?
Well, never.
Yeah, well, that's my point. Jericho took two good shots, and how do you know he didn't suffer a concussion? I gotta believe he might even have brain damage.
Nice vertical suplex, and now following up, side slam. Nicely done. Joey Abs hooks the leg. Referee Chad Patton in position, and just a tube count. So we'll see China and Chris Jericho meet for the Intercontinental title. We'll also see the Big Show defend the World Wrestling Federation Championship against the Big Boss Man. That's next Sunday, live on pay-per-view at Armageddon. Head of steam, Joey Abs drops the leg across the throat, stealing a page out of D'Lo Brown's book. Doesn't hook the leg, and Brown sneaks his shoulder out at two.
You know, Kevin, I've got to think that Stephanie McMahon obviously feels horrible about the situation she put herself in and wound up burying Triple H.
There probably is no more humiliating situation than what Stephanie McMahon endured last Monday night on Raw. And we know that Stephanie is wanting to take responsibility for her actions and get out of this situation that she got herself in. She made that very clear this past Thursday on SmackDown. Of course, we'll take you back to SmackDown a little later on, and we'll show you the whole interaction. Wait a second. Power slam out of the corner. And another near fall. We'll show you everything that happened this Thursday as the newly married couple began, well, I don't even want to say their life together, because they don't have a life together at all.
Think of the emotional roller coaster Tess must be going through
now.
Man, the ups and downs.
It certainly was a night of loss for both Tess and Stephanie McMahon. It's a night the McMahon family will never forget. And I have a feeling Vince McMahon is going to look to make Triple H pay big time next Sunday at Armageddon. Great maneuver by Joey Abs, who's carrying this fight to D'Lo Brown. Did not hook the leg, though, Tom. D'Lo able to kick out. Is that inexperience or overconfidence?
Most definitely inexperience. I think that Joey Abs has just enough confidence to get him some success here, but he's got to know when to hook the leg and cover a little quicker than that.
Well, he's going for a modified power bomb, and look at this. D'Lo Brown hits the sky high.
It looks like it took something out of D'Lo, too.
Let's see who'll be the first man to get back to his feet. Referee Chad Patton's applying the count.
And I like the way the Mean Street Posse is circling the ring.
Well, I don't like the way they're circling the ring.
Good to support each other in a match like this.
D'Lo Brown battling the odds and now beginning to fight back. Firing back with some right hands. But Joey Abs counters the reverse. Now D'Lo ducks a clothesline, delivers a beautiful forearm. Boy, it looks like D'Lo Brown is beginning to write his own comeback, write his own future. Much the same way that Mankind now has the number one best-selling book. Have a Nice Day, when you open up your New York Times this Sunday, will be number one on the bestseller list.
Oh, Pete Guess, up on the apron, got nailed for that one.
Well, wait a minute now, look on the other side. Oh. Joey Abs just clobbers D'Lo with a clothesline. And now Rodney's rolling in. Here goes the Mean Street Posse's M.O.
What are they going to do here?
What is Rodney doing? Oh! High-risk maneuver. Joey Abs pays for it. D'Lo Brown, the leg chop. Cover. One, two.
He got him. Yeah, but thanks to Rodney coming off that top rope.
Here is your winner, D'Lo Brown.
Well, Joey Abs may have been done in by his own partner, but D'Lo Brown standing tall and would love to have an opportunity at the European title. We'll find out, folks, what happens as we count down to Armageddon.